This session was officiated by the Honorable Justice Dr. Winfred Nyondo Nabisinde, a judge from the Jinja High Court. This session is aimed at briefing people on the importance, policies and guidelines of a special session which will be conducted in a period of 41 days at Kamuli Chief Magistrate Court. All stakeholders met at Kamuli Magistrate Court, chaired by the Grade 1 Magistrate, Kevin Runji Natkunda Joy.
This is not the first of its kind. This kind of special sessions have been ongoing in the country for quite some time, and we have specific objectives which were set between the judiciary and our partners who are funding these particular special sessions. These sessions were specifically organized in response to the urgent need to counter the growing menace of sexual and gender-based violence offences, as well as the fulfillment of Uganda's commitment to eradicate SGBV under the Maputo Declaration on Gender Mainstreaming.
Justice Nabisinde says 47 cases of sexual gender-based violence, aggravated defilement, rape and cases of child trafficking will be addressed. She further noted that the court is open to the public and some radio shows will be held to teach residents on how these cases are handled.
Being a special session for SGBV, the majority are aggravated defilements, which is tried by the High Court, and rape. We do have, one matter which combines both murder and aggravated defilement, and a few cases of aggravated trafficking in persons, in children mostly. But you will find that the bulk of the cases are aggravated defilement as per the cause list.
Mudumbu C. Daniel commended the judiciary for starting this session. He is hopeful that the community will benefit from the trainings.
Cases of sexual and gender-based violence in the Busoga region are on the increase. But when we take Kamuli in particular, we find that the number is not so much high considering to other places. However, the session that we are holding today is for approximately 47 cases. It would have been 50, but other cases are not yet ready for trial. So,
Mboyizi Joshua, the Kamuli probation officer, noted that most of the cases were registered during the COVID-19 lockdown.
You see, Kamuli have registered many cases of violence against the children, especially deferment cases, but during that period of COVID, the number was big. We registered so many instances of violence, but after COVID, now children have gone back to school, so the number is reducing.
Balinango Fred, the district councillor, applauded the judicial department for bringing services near to Kamuli.
The rate of these cases is going to reduce because the rate has been high due to ignorance of the people. They didn't know, but now, since we have got this chance, I'm sure the rate is going to reduce down.
Story by Nathan Sengoba for the news in Kamuli.